Deca.
How are you today?
I'm fine. What's up, Deck?
Well, I've got some good news, gooder news.
Oh, wonderful.
Bad news.
Oh.
Badder news and baddest news.
A girl named Julie from the future being number 11.
She works for Nail Tape.
Aw, man.
She's Slumin Underfoot's latest acquisition.
Another Perky Hunter?
Of course.
Aw, yay.
Which makes involving her in the restoration project that much more difficult.
Hey, would you look at that? Now what is he in the 21st century doing with a replica of the Northern Star? And those other ships? These life-size versions won't be built for another 300 years. What's he doing with copies of them?
Well, forget about that for now. The signals indicate there's something behind you, some kind of device. It seems to be emitting three separate sets of ambient room tones. This could be Platz's parallel dimension device.
Device that can bring parallel dimensions together?
Well, that's what Mr. Underfoot told me to look for before we started this thing.
Okay. Hey, wait, there's something else over here. Just look at this. It looks like a suit of some sort. And this is some kind of chamber. It's covered in ion receptors. They're all dead, though. I'm not getting any power signals, no AC, no DC.
There are a lot of ion trails behind you, though. There's some point where they're all converging, just above the ground and yet below that device somewhere. I think somewhere tucked underneath, there could be a memory pack that will really help us out.
Yeah, I think I know where it's coming from. Underneath here. Let me just reach down. Feel around. I'm not sure exactly what it is, but there's something loose hanging here. I think this may be it by the looks of it.
Yep, I think that's it. The readings are going off the scale here. Is that really what it looks like? Circuitry with wood, sinew, and leather?
That's what they're made of, all right. Some kind of hybrid device.
Okay, let's make an analysis of it. So we can break down some of the compounds. Okay, get out your Dumaflachi. Set it to scansmitter. I'll start the recording in this end.
What was that?
I'm checking it out, don't worry. Just start your analysis.
Can I ask you something, Toby?
Must?
I must.
Go ahead.
Why am I not allowed to know your name? What do I call you?
Well, this is your first time, John, isn't it?
Isn't that obvious?
Only to me. I've done this hundreds of times. And to answer your questions, even though it's breaking the rules, just call me Obby. A-W-B, Obby.
There it is again. Something's happening over there, near that pad thing.
Look at your scanner. Check the quantum field. See if there's anything amiss.
Recorder? Deliver the following missive to Platz's labs once I and the hybrids have left here. Dear Mr. Professor Wenzel Platz-Mockerson and Company, thank you very much for finding the center of the universe for me. It will make a great central location for my new universal headquarters. If you're listening to this right now, you'll be noticing a change in the world around you. And if I have anything to do with it, you'll be all babbling fools wallowing around in a pool of genetic muck wondering where your labs and studios are. Of course, you can really thank yourself for involving Mr. White Bear in helping to open up the parallel dimensions that have served me ever so well. Rest assured knowing that your own inventions have caused your very own downfall. Thank you once again. Yours ever so insincerely, Mr. Slumin Underfoot, King of the Universe. End missive. Now to start the millennial disruptions.